It's Michael from Overland Bound. Recently, the trusty rig and I went out to Corral Hollow Trail. That's out Highway 4 near Lake Alpine, California. If you go to overlandbound.com, you'll find a map of exactly how to get there, and I hope you make the trip because it's one of my favorite places to go. While I was camping, I thought it might be interesting to mount the GoPro camera on the dash of the Land Cruiser and record the path from the very top bluff, one of my favorite locations, down to the pavement, which is Highway 4. Now, it's one of the longest videos I've made. It's about 15 minutes of trail travel with quite a bit of dialogue, but I thought it may be more interesting if I also included images of other things I did while I was out there. That way, you really get a full perspective of everything that you can do. If you write comments or ask me questions in the video, I'll be glad to answer them, let you know what you might need to go out there, but it's one of my favorite locations, and I really hope you get the chance to make the trip. Enjoy the video, and look forward to seeing you out there. Hey everyone, so I'm leaving Corral Hollow Trail, that's by Lake Alpine, California, and I thought I'd just jump on real quick and do a little dialogue as I go down the trail. I'm about to go through a real pretty area. It's a meadow that you drive through on this trail, and at this time of year, which is June 1st, 2014, It's pretty. It's got the grass is starting to grow, and I'm taking this part of the trail pretty quickly. I'm way aired down. I'm at about 10 PSI, and that's because I was going through some snow and over some heavy rock. So it's a really smooth ride right now. I also know this section of trail very well, so I'm able to go at a fairly decent clip. However, you always got to be careful, don't get cocky, because there's always that rock that looks like it's a little bit lower than it is. It snags your undercarriage. And that's never fun. I've got the cargo on the rig strapped down very well. The straps, you know, for the cargo on the roof provide front and back support and lateral support as well. Now here's a tree in the road, and I'm going to go ahead and drive over the tree instead of over the edge. I'll take this slow. There we go. All right. And this branch always snags me, so I'm going to run up on the hill here to avoid undue cargo damage. There we go. And on this rig, which I love, I don't mind pinstriping and brush, but I don't want to dent it, right? Like, that's kind of my area of comfort. So I err on the side of caution if it looks like I'm going to take some damage. And here we've got a fairly narrow section of trail. I've been on this trail. Let's see, up and down, going up and down this trail. Maybe 10 times. About 5 visits. I've probably been up and down the trail even more than that, but I really like it. It's gorgeous up here, and this is a little tricky, narrow spot. There we go. This trip, I'm on a solo trip. I try and do one solo trip a year, but I love bringing people up here as well and sharing it with them. When you go up to the top, I have other video on the site that shows the awesome view once you get up there. And now we're starting to emerge into this meadow. Now, Corral Hollow is a moderate trail. It is not difficult. You can see I'm clipping along pretty good on this trail. There's a trail close by called Slick Rock Trail. And Slick Rock is a very technical trail. If you go the whole route, you can go part of the way, and it's actually nice for family because you can get down there by the river and just have a nice lunch or camp or whatever you want to do. But if you go the whole route, there's some very technical trail rock crawling all along Slick Rock. It's a very fun ride. I've done it 3 times, but I'm not always in the mood to do it. Again, I'm not out here to tear up my truck. You do get to see some beautiful scenery, but it's hard on the rigs. And if you're not set up for it, you shouldn't be going on it. It's a trail that needs decent clearance, some big tires, 35s I would say are minimum. I do it. I've got about 3 inches of clearance on my rig, and that's minimum. You really want more to go on Slick Rock, but it's close by. And so I come out to Lake Alpine a lot because there's quite a bit, something for everyone. Wahoo! Ooh! Ooh! And that's what I mean, just when you think you know the trail, something reaches out and grabs you. Now that's all armor under the body, so those thunks that you heard weren't in any of the sensitive nasty bits under there. But it's still. Something you want to avoid. Stay out here, something you notice is that the landscape changes every day. Around the campsite there's snow, but every day that snow recedes. These plants in the meadow get larger. The trail changes year to year, so it's always an adventure coming out here to see how the trail has changed. And the Forest Service, they come out fairly early in the spring and cut the trees that have fallen over the trail, and the trail is blocked every year. The winter, the snow gets very deep up here, and trees fall every year, and trees fall on the trail every year, so they come and clear the trail. But really, if you come up here in April, you may not get through. You might not get very far. As you can see, there's still patches of snow on the ground. And I've come up early in the spring and not been able to get through because the snow is covering the trail. And, you know, it doesn't matter how great your rig is. There's a certain point where you can't go much further, or at least it's not fun to, unless you want to winch your vehicle from tree to tree, which isn't very practical. I have done that when I came up here and the trail was covered. I winched myself through a couple of snow drifts that covered the trail so that I could get to a decent campsite, and had a great visit. There's a couple of minor water crossings on this trail. I mean, a couple of small creeks. Of course, earlier in the year, they're deeper. Little mud bogging. Keep the rattles to a minimum on this rig. But I've got a couple that I cannot track down. One of them, I suspect, has something to do with the swing out rear bumper. And it might be rattling a little bit. But then there's also one. In the suspension that I haven't tracked down yet. Now, I'm running BF Goodrich KM2s on this truck, and like I said, it's aired down right now to 10 PSI, and so the little bit of mud and the water crossings you see me going through are no problem whatsoever. These tires are great. I've had them aired down to practically zero, no problem. And you know, they are decent highway tires as well. You do hear a little bit of a hum, but it's not bad. This FZJ 80 has a higher compression inline 4.5 liter six cylinder motor, and
I did not feel the power difference when I switched to these larger tires. I'm very happy with the choice so far, and I'll probably run them again. In the trail for the first time of the year, I run pretty slow. I crawl. I'm a pretty slow driver. But on this trip, I've been up and down this trail a couple of times, and I'm headed home, so I'm not going as slow as I normally do. Here's an example of a fresh tree fall that happened this year. And the Forest Service said, you know what? You can get around by driving off the trail, so we're just gonna take a little of the tree out. That worked. Yeah, it's one thing. Sometimes the trail changes because a tree will fall into the middle of it, but you can still get around. So the Forest Service doesn't bother with it. Here, I don't even think you'll hear my tires spin. Just like that. Like I said, tires are really good. Now, they have their limits too. Crawled up on a couple of snowdrifts and tires just spin. This rig does have the front and rear locking differentials, so I can lock everything up. That means that when everything's locked, all tires must turn at the same time. There's absolutely no differential, and it really does become a rolling tank. However, even so, in deep snow, you get to your limit. Me earning some new pinstriping on the outside. Now, this trail is moderate, but if you've got a really pretty truck, really nice wheels, low profile tires, maybe some chrome undercarriage, I wouldn't recommend it. Because you're gonna get scratched. That's just the price you pay for coming out here. But if you've got a real camping rig, off-road rig, overland rig, I imagine you're not too concerned with that. Water crossing. All right, puddle. This does get deep earlier in the year. Right now it's pretty mild, but. Fresh fallen trees. I got secrets from you, you got secrets from me, because you're so worried about what I'm gonna think. Baby, I'm this is about as technical as Crow Hollow Trail gets. It's not that technical. This is a lot smoother than it was last year. It's practically a highway through here. I'm not in 4-low right now. I'll switch it to 4-low up here to go over some rocks, but I've been letting gravity do the work. Okay, so I was wrong about my reasons for us falling out. And here we go, we're going to 4-low. Now, if you want to get technical on this trail, you can. Here's some boulders for crawling. But I'm not that kind of driver. I'll take the easy route. I don't want to damage my truck. I want it to last a long time. And the more I beat it up, the more time I spend in the shop. And that's less time out here. Now, I do. For demonstration purposes, I'll run over some technical trail. I did a clip I haven't posted yet of rock crawling over a boulder with and without lockers on, and you can really see the difference. That was close. Didn't quite hit, but almost. The rear of this thing sticks way out. If you guys are familiar with the Land Cruiser 80. got quite an ass on it, so you're bumping it a lot. I've got a quarter inch of steel plate back there, so it's fairly well protected, but it drags a lot. And then I got to get out and go get my trailer hitch cover. And I took the hard way. I know I've said it. Well, you want to drive over the rocks, the big tall rocks. You don't want to straddle them with your tires. You want to put your tires on them and drive over them. That way you don't hit anything underneath. So if you find yourself in rocks and you got to pick a path, plant your tires on the rocks. Four low, so it sounds all exciting out there. And guess what? We're coming to the end of Coral Hollow Trail. That was practically the full drive up to the top of the bluff. Beautiful, beautiful country. There's never any, I shouldn't say never any, but competition up here for sites is practically non-existent. My only concern is I don't get my favorite site, but it's never happened. So that beautiful ridgetop camping site, no one's ever been there. And I don't see people out here either. Now, if I come out here and you're in my spot, you gotta pack up and go. just kidding. It's first come, first serve out here for everyone to enjoy. All right. Now, I see concrete. That means I have to air up my tires. That's gonna take a little while, and then I'll hit the highway. Thanks for listening.